I want to create some wavy lines or lines that oscillate up and down, basically just go up, down, up, down, up, down. To do that, I'm going to use my Bezier curves. The first one I'm going to try is the freeform line. I'm going to click on freeform line and draw it up, down, up, down, up, down, up, and down. Well, that's the idea that I wanted to do, but I wanted them a little more symmetrical. So the next thing I'm going to try is our polygon. Clicking on our start point, and I do have snap to grid on, so this will snap right in. I'm releasing my left mouse button. Clicking, 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 and double clicking. Gives me kind of what I'm looking for, but I want to round these out. So I'm going to hit F8, which brings up edit points. And I'm going to select these top points and give them a smooth transition. Now I'm going to select all the bottom points and do the same thing. Now that's a little more what I was looking for. Now I want to try that just using my curve tool. But before I do that, let's select this oscillating line again and select these bottom points. And we notice that all our control points just go right and left of our point. And the same thing on the top. So if we know how to position our control points, we can make a curved line just like this. Let's review our curve tool by clicking that. And I'm clicking on a point. I'm going up and over to the right, releasing my mouse button, coming down to the right, double clicking. And when I click on this left point, it shows me my control point is where I released my mouse button. Now that we know how to position our control point, we should be able to create these oscillating lines with our curve tool. So I'm going to click on my curve tool, come down and click on my first point, and I want my control point to be to the right halfway. I'm releasing my mouse button, going up to my second point. Now I'm holding down my mouse button, and I'm moving it to where I want to place my control point, over to the left of my point, releasing my mouse button, coming down and to the right where I want to position my next transition point, clicking, holding to where I want my next control point, which is right under the center. I'm releasing my mouse button, going up and to the right. I'm going to press and hold my mouse button, come over to the left, halfway, release my mouse button, come down to the right, press and hold my mouse button, come back halfway, release my mouse button, up and to the right, press and hold mouse button, move it halfway, release, come down and to the right, press, hold, move halfway, release, up to the right, press, hold, release halfway over, and come down to the bottom where I'll double click. And our last one, I need to fix that, so I'm going to click on this point and move my control point in halfway. So now if I select my top control points, we can see that they are all positioned, forming a line across the top just as we would expect. Let's insert a new slide. And on this one, I'm going to add a rectangle and a circle. I'm going to copy my rectangle. I'm pulling down Control and moving that one below and doing the same with our circle. Holding down Control, moving it to the other side. Now I want to create a path which is Bezier Curves, that starts in our left, comes around, then below the bottom square, up to the left of this circle, and ends to our right of our rectangle on the top. There's a couple of ways I can do this. The first one is to click on our curve and try and remember that when I click, my first curve, because this is an endpoint, will go right along the line that I'm creating. Now when I release the mouse button, that's going to be my control point for my first curve. My second point, I want to be right about here, the bottom of the rectangle. And I want my Bezier line to go up, so why don't I snap it to the grid there. And I'm going up 2 and over 1. Now I'll come over to the other side of my rectangle, and I want to make this a Bezier curve. So I'm going to click and hold, and this time I want my Bezier curve to come at an angle like this. So I will go down 2 and over 1, releasing my mouse button. And my last point, I will double click it to end my path. And I need to still set this endpoint control point. So I'm going to click on that point, and I've got my strings intertwined showing me that I'm going to move my control point. So there we have it. We got our line to go in between these circles. And if I didn't like them, I can also move it in a little more. Let's insert a new slide and look at another way to do this. This time, I'm going to delete the line. This time, I'm going to put it in as a polygon. I'm just going to click. So I'm going to click and hold down from my first point to my second point. Click on my third point. Click on my fourth point, double clicking. Now, I want to select all of these and make them curves. This time I'm going to move my line in. And there we have the same thing.